Solve. The absolute value of 4x plus 8 is greater than 12. Well, remember that the absolute value bars mean the distance from 0, the distance from the origin. So if I put down a number line here, and I put 0 right in the middle where it belongs, and then I put negative 12 here and a positive 12 here, we're not graphing the solution yet. I'm just showing what's going to happen here. Well, 4x plus 8. 4x plus 8 could be greater than 12. And we'll show that right there. Could be greater than 12. But it could also have a distance. It's a distance of 12 units. So it could also be off to the left 12 units. So let's put 4x plus 8 over here and graph that. That's going to set up two inequalities. So let's write those down, right? Just take it right from the graph there. You have 4x plus 8 is less than negative 12. Or you have the other scenario where 4x plus 8 is greater than positive 12, 12 units from 0. And yeah, this will set up two solutions, but that's okay. That's what we want. So here we're going to solve these equations. Let's subtract 8 from each side, and we can even solve these simultaneously just because we're doing the same thing to isolate the variable, to isolate x. And what we get on this inequality is 4x is less than negative 20. Or, with our other inequality, we have 4x is greater than 4. Our next step to isolate the variable is to divide by the coefficient, divide by 4. So let's show that. Divide everything by 4. That's going to give us as a result, x is less than negative 5. Or we have x is greater than 1. So we really have this, our solution contains these two sets of numbers. You can write this in set notation if you'd like, less than negative 5. So set notation from negative infinity, and you always use the rounded parentheses there for negative infinity or positive infinity, up to negative 5, rounded parentheses because it's negative 5 is not included. Or, and now we can say these numbers as well, greater than 1 and to the right forever. Infinity is not a number, it's just an idea. Goes on forever. Okay, so all of these numbers, let's graph that. Let's graph all of these numbers so we can show visually our solutions. And I say solutions because it's a bunch of numbers. It's one, not one, but greater than one. Two, three, four, and all the decimals in between, and less than negative 5. So negative 6, negative 7, negative a million would satisfy this inequality with absolute value. Okay, let's lay down this negative 5. I'll put it right here. And I'm going to put a 0 about here, and I'll put a 1 right about here just to try to make this to scale. And to graph this, I'll use an open circle. Negative 5 is not included, but everything to the left is. All those numbers left less than negative 5 would satisfy this inequality. And likewise, all the numbers to the right of positive 1 would satisfy this inequality. So I know even though we started with an or, we can say all of these numbers and all of these numbers satisfy this inequality, or our solutions to this inequality.